Julie? Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good.
Definitely.
So Preeti, so you are an animal lover and
Right.
you have been an activist as well, whether it was relating to Avni, some months back. And I mean, I'm really inspired by your actions. I'm really inspired by what you do for the animals. So what do you think about this condition of strays in our society? And what do you think could be, the general public could do? I mean, even if they are not animal lovers as such, but what do you think they could do?
See, first of all, we need to understand that we have to educate the people around about stray and animals, and who do we have to first make our targets? Our children, right?
Correct.
Children should be educated because tomorrow they'll grow up. This should be the first thing in our mind. Secondly is, then we have to move on to the See, in our society, I've seen there are children who would want to play, but they're scared. So we all should get into some kind of a program where we, with the help of these dogs, whether they are stray or like a pedigree dog, whatever it is, we should help them to understand. That dogs not only bite, they play, and when they are playing with us, sometimes we might get hurt, so we have to understand that much, huh?
Correct.
And this kind of education has to be taken up in the society, so that this is what I want to do first. I'm even thinking of doing certain programs. I don't know when it will start, but I am keen on it, and I want to start this. Secondly is, now if we see from the other perspective, that human beings, because they are scared that their children will be bitten. So if you have a child, you will definitely take care of your child. Then you will think of anything else. So that also should be kept in mind, and our dogs, roadside dogs or society dogs, should be trained that way, that they don't, even if they have to play, they should only go to those people who like them. So all that should be, implemented, and some people should come ahead and train dogs. Stray dogs, like I have been training the dogs in my society. They listen to the command, go, sit, eat, don't trouble, keep quiet, leave. So these few things they understand.
Okay, so how many days do you think they took to actually, start obeying your commands? Means.
Huh, they did not take much time. I gave them good amount of, like, say 2 weeks.
Okay, that's good.
2 weeks. But you need to be regular. You cannot skip the training. When I used to feed them, when I had come, they were young, I used to feed them, they all used to pounce on me for food. And I used to have that bowl of food. Then I made them to sit there, sit down. Now they all, whenever they see me with a bowl, they immediately go and take their places and sit down. I still have to improve on some more grounds. But the thing is, dogs learn very fast. And I have trained dogs who are old also. It is not that, yes, of course, when they are young, they learn better. But even old dogs can learn.
Yeah, sure. Any dog.
Right, so it's just because in our society some of them are very open, and they are very cooperating, and some of them are very rigid. But I feel we will get these kinds of people everywhere, and we have to understand their side as well as our dogs. That's what I want.
Okay, so what do you think, how important is sterilization for our streeties? Even if one family starts doing the sterilization of their area's dogs, I mean,
Now
I mean.
this is a good question, because sterilization of dogs, definitely, like, I went to one of the doctors, very senior doctors, and he was very angry that no, it should be stopped.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because like our Indian breed cows,
mm-hmm.
the number has reduced. He said that they are not found. I am not sure about it, but the Indian cows are not found at all now, because they have been replaced by these Jersey cows.
Okay.
So the Indian breed is over, extinct.
Okay.
So similarly, our Indian dog should not be, the numbers after reducing and reducing should not
mm-hmm.
eradicate completely. That is my worry. So for this reason, even if we are taking up a mission to sterilize the dogs of the society or that area, there should be some dogs left.
Yeah.
Yeah? Just like a couple of dogs should be left so that they can breed and the numbers may increase. After they give birth in... to like
one litter or something,
one season day, then we can think of, not all of them, because what happens is if we think there are many dogs and if we think that every dog gives birth and then we sterilize the dog, then again the number will increase a lot. So somewhere we have to, even I am not sure of everything, because I am not a very big activist. I'm a very small person who does a little bit here and there. I don't call myself an activist. I'm just a helper, a caretaker. I do a very little. I'm bound with responsibilities, so I can't move into,
No, I think you are doing your part as much as you can.
Yeah,
and I think if everybody starts doing that one by one, it will create a huge difference in the long term.
Yeah.
So then, I mean, don't think your contribution is small. Your contribution is extremely huge from your side.
So,
as you can see, I'm really inspired by her, and she has got amazing views. So I think the same thinking should be inculcated in everybody's minds, rather than hating the dogs, rather than throwing stones at them or relocating them elsewhere. I think we should start thinking from a more human perspective and a more creative perspective, and a more, in fact, which will be effective in the long run. So I'll be back with more videos. Till then, goodbye.